Did China just leapfrog Silicon Valley in AI? Some say China is living in 2050, while the West is stuck two decades behind. And before you think that's just hype, make sure you watch this video to the very end, because I'm breaking down these shocking details of how China may have just out-innovated the birthplace of Google, Facebook, Tesla, and even ChatGPT itself.
Here's what we're covering. A quick background on Silicon Valley, how it rose from dusty garages to become the global capital of innovation. Where Silicon Valley stands today, and why cracks are starting to show. And finally, how China has built an ecosystem so fast, so massive, and so futuristic that it's making Silicon Valley look slow. And trust me, the last section is where things get wild, because it reveals why some experts believe the next AI superpower won't come from California at all.
Let's rewind. Silicon Valley isn't just a place, it's a symbol. It's the birthplace of Apple in a garage, Google out of a dorm room, Facebook in a college apartment. For decades, this tiny strip of land in California defined the cutting edge of technology. It gave us the internet as we know it, smartphones, social media, cloud computing, and now AI models like ChatGPT. But here's the twist. While Silicon Valley was climbing its way up, China was quietly building its own playbook. Not a copycat, something different, something faster, something scaled at a level the Valley never had. And today, many argue China isn't just catching up, it's racing ahead.
And this is where the story gets fascinating. Because when you look at how China moves, it feels like they're operating in the year 2050. Massive data, government backing, instant product launches, AI embedded into daily life, from super apps to surveillance systems. Meanwhile, the West is tangled in regulation, lawsuits, and debates that leave them 20 years behind. So the real question is, has China already out-innovated Silicon Valley?
Let's start with something Silicon Valley actually struggles with. Speed. In the US, building an AI product often means months of red tape, layers of approvals, multiple funding rounds, and regulators breathing down your neck. In China, things move differently. Picture this. A new AI app idea is pitched on Monday. By Friday, there's already a working prototype with a million users testing it. Companies like ByteDance, the maker of TikTok, didn't just build a social app. They built one of the most advanced AI recommendation engines on Earth. That wasn't an accident. It was the product of an ecosystem where iteration is lightning fast and move fast isn't just a slogan, it's survival. And here's the kicker. Silicon Valley is starting to realize it can't match that raw velocity.
But speed alone doesn't win wars. What really matters is whether China's model can produce breakthroughs, not just fast clones. So, are we seeing signs of original innovation that might outshine Silicon Valley? Let's dig deeper. Here's something Silicon Valley simply can't compete with: population scale. China has over a billion people online. That means more data, more testing, more feedback loops. AI feeds on data like humans feed on oxygen. The bigger the data set, the smarter the model. Think about facial recognition. In the US, it's a controversial niche. In China, it's everywhere. Train stations, shopping malls, even public restrooms. Every scan adds more data, more training, more refinement. This isn't just theory. It's why companies like SenseTime and Megvi have become world leaders in computer vision. Because when you've got hundreds of millions of people interacting with your system every single day, your AI doesn't just learn fast, it evolves.
Now let's talk about something Silicon Valley doesn't have: government as a business partner. In the US, tech companies often battle Washington. Think hearings, antitrust lawsuits, endless debates. In China, the government sets national goals for AI and then pours billions into making them happen. AI isn't just a tech product in China. It's part of the country's five-year plans, its military strategy, its vision of national power. That means subsidies for startups, dedicated AI research zones, and universities churning out engineers at a volume the US can't match. Now, is that a double-edged sword? Absolutely. The same government that fuels innovation also sets strict boundaries. But here's the thing. When the state decides AI is the future and backs it with resources, the entire ecosystem levels up. But wait, does that mean Silicon Valley is doomed? Not exactly. Because there are some things the Valley does that China can't easily replicate, and those things might be its secret weapon. Here's where the Valley still shines: creativity and openness. The culture of crazy ideas, of moonshots that sound impossible, that's deeply embedded in the Valley's DNA. Google betting on self-driving cars before anyone thought it was viable. OpenAI releasing models that spark global conversations. Tesla pushing electric cars when oil was king. And then there's the openness. Open source libraries, academic papers, global collaboration. Silicon Valley thrives on networks that stretch across the world. That kind of freedom to experiment, to fail big, to share openly, it's not as easy to cultivate in a system where the government calls the shots. So while China might dominate on speed and scale, the Valley still has this unpredictable X factor. So what happens when China's speed, scale, and state power collides with Silicon Valley's creativity, openness, and daring? We're not just looking at two tech hubs. We're looking at two competing visions for the future of AI. One is centralized, fast, data-rich, government-backed. The other is decentralized, experimental, globally networked. And here's the reality. Neither side has a guaranteed win. The breakthroughs of the next decade, whether it's in AGI, robotics, biotech, or something we can't even imagine, could come from either ecosystem. So did China just out-innovate Silicon Valley? Maybe. Or maybe the better question is, what happens when the true breakthroughs only come when East and West are forced to learn from each other? Because here's the truth. The AI revolution isn't going to stop at borders. And the race we're watching right now isn't just about who wins. It's about what kind of future they build. So I'll leave you with this. If the next ChatGPT or the next TikTok or the next AI breakthrough comes out of Beijing instead of Palo Alto, would the world even be ready for it? Stay tuned, because this story is just getting started.